I'm a physicist, but I took a course on American law. I literally went and sat down with law students and I took a traditional lecture-based course on American law. And it was in the sixth year of the PhD program in physics. Even more interesting, the Department of Physics paid the full tuition for this law course. They were glad to do that. In this video, I will explain why a physicist should take a course on American law. When I discovered the new computer technology, our expectation at the Department of Physics was that the university should file for patents, sell the technology to the industry, and pay our share of income. The university had a specific office for this purpose. They called it the Office for Technology Transfer, but it turned out that the University of Alabama had serious problems regarding technology transfer. The Office for Technology Transfer was not transparent. Their formal income from patent royalties was very small, almost zero. Either they didn't have a considerable income, or probably they were hiding their income. So they were not formally processing all the money they received. Either way, the share of inventors was practically zero. When I took the course on American law, I did more research on this matter. Let's look at one of the communications we had. I will show you my email to them and their reply.
Hi, Whitney. This semester I had a course on overview of American law to familiarize myself with the legal issues of intellectual property, patents, etc. My final project in this course is about process of getting a patent. I wonder if you can give me some information about the patents are made in UA. It would be helpful if you can give me some information about number of patents each year, number of patents which are commercialized annually, the income of university from royalties of patents.
Now let's see the answer of the Office for Technology Transfer. It does not mention the monetary income they get from technology transfer.
Hi Ali. Please see the information below. FY16 stats. OTT saw the disclosure of 50 new technologies, filed 48 patent applications, executed 60 different agreements, and had 21 patents issued. Whitney Huff, Assistant Director, Office for Technology Transfer.
Then I tried to get more information, and specifically how much they make from these patents. And this was the answer.
Hi Ali. There is not a report per se that you can use to cite. I think it might be best to cite it as a conversation with the Office for Technology Transfer. All of the patent information will be public on the USPTO website, but only after the applications hit the 18-month mark. Executed agreements are things such as non-disclosure, material transfer, and various licensing agreements. For FY16, OTT brought in $300,000. Hope this helps. Whitney Huff, Assistant Director, Office for Technology Transfer.
So the whole income from all kinds of technology-related contracts was only $300,000. Sometimes the local industries use the research facilities of the university. This $300,000 income was a fee for such collaborations, and it was a very small amount of money for a university. The salaries and expenditure of the Office for Technology Transfer was few million dollars, and they spent another few million dollars to make the patents. Who was paying all those expenses? Why was the university using its income from tuition to pay for technology transfer? What was their benefit? The university evaluated the new computer technology at $500 million. And their whole income for 1 year was $300,000. How could they handle a $500 million technology? Considering this situation, I had to start my own company to establish the new computer technology. And this brings up the second reason for taking a course on American law. I was not an entrepreneur. I was a scientist. I had the skill set for an academic career. To start a business, a different set of skills were necessary. Maybe a younger entrepreneur would try to learn from trial and error. But I wanted to make the right decisions. So I took a course on American law to learn the correct steps towards establishing a technology business in the US. Through the course, I learned about the intellectual property law, the contract law. I learned how the legal system works, how to hire a good lawyer, and many other things. Then I started my own company, PzRAM Technologies, and I decided to use this technology to cure diabetes, which I will talk about in a separate video. Thank you for your attention.